Hello and welcome to this quick overview of AFX 4. In the next few minutes, I will try to give you a good impression about the possibilities you have when working with AFX. First of all, let me show you the basic concept. AFX works with a top-down approach that requires the following steps. Create a skeleton model, either in the assembly, a separate model, or in a real skeleton model. Assemble beams, define joints between beams, and assemble connectors and fasteners. And finally, create drawings and the bill of material. Let's start with the basic design. First, you want to select a profile from the library. AFX offers a rich library with steel beams and profile systems like Bosch or Item. But we want an angle beam here, so we take the size 50 by 6. Okay. And after selecting the beam, we just have to position it. Here we have three possibilities. Assemble on a straight curve, between two points, or on a bent curve. So you select the method and select the given references and the profile will be assembled. By the way, the orange color indicates that this is a preview. So to complete the positioning, we can also move and rotate the beam until we are satisfied. Now let's get into the details. With the Move tool, you will find similar commands as in the Position Profile dialog. But you have some more capabilities. You can move or rotate a bunch of profiles at once and also use the Move to Other Entity command. As you can see, I first select the surface of the beam I want to move and then the reference geometry. AFX will then align these two surfaces. Two more. Okay. Good, and we're done. Next up, we want to create some joints between the beams, as most of them are overlapping at the moment. Due to the fact that we reused the angle beam in all three levels of the shelf truck, we only need to create two mitre joints and all other instances change accordingly. Okay. After that, we will assemble some connector elements. Like the Profiles library, this library also offers a lot of different typical steel construction items, as well as profile systems. Here we want to assemble a weld plate to offer some support for our handle. When selecting the part in the library, we will get forwarded to its configuration page. Here we can change the dimensions of the part to fulfill our needs, and afterwards we just have to place the part in the assembly by selecting the references shown in the picture. To complete this design, I will quickly add another joint to the handle. Okay. Next up, we need to hold all these beams together. We will need some fasteners for that. But before we can assemble them, we have to define their position. Therefore, we can use the handy point pattern tool. With a what you see is what you get approach, you can develop the pattern that works for you and then copy it to the other beams. So just enter the dimensions here. Two holes is enough. And okay. And afterwards I will copy this point pattern to the other beams. As they are reused, I don't have to do this very often. So okay, repeat. One here, repeat, one here. And that should be fine. Okay. Now, to assemble the fasteners, we use the Intelligent Fastener extension. It is also included in the full version of AFX. Here you just select the Assemble on Point or Axis command, select the hole for the connection, select the screw head surface and the nut surface. Configure the screw connection the way you want it, and as we use the AFX point pattern functionality, we are also asked if we want to pattern the connection. As you can see, the holes are also drilled in the attaching part. If I suppress the screw connection here. Okay. Cool. You are not a big fan of drawing creation? In that case, we just have the right tools for you. With AFX, you can create all project drawings of a complete assembly at once. It even places the dimensions for you. And you're done. Okay, to be fair, you have to adjust the position of the dimensions afterwards to make the drawing pretty. But other than that, you are fine to go to manufacturing. For the bomb, we also have developed a neat tool that lets you define your own item numbers and even allows item numbers on the project parts. Also, it has a technology that will try to find duplicate parts and give them the same item number. One example for that is the weld plate we used for the handle. The second plate was assembled as a copy, but it has the exact same shape. What else do we need? Maybe some nice tables that will help us in the calculation process. For that, we offer a stock length table that will show you the total amount of beams required, and a cut list that will tell you what beams to make from what raw material. Okay. You can also create drawing views directly in the assembly drawing. Enter the scale, select the beam and place it, and also add dimensions to it. And if you want to, also the item number. So, to sum this video up, AFX is a really intuitive and easy to use software. It also saves you a heck of time compared to standard Creo. Due to its intelligent connections between the parts, errors are a thing of the past. You can also modify all parts, shapes, sizes and dimensions with the easy-to-use dialogs of AFX. You can use AFX even for very big projects. For the whole construction process, external references get avoided wherever it is possible. And last but not least, AFX will allow you to customize it to your needs, create your own library parts, and even adapt the software to your personal needs. So, if you have any questions, feel free to contact me, and thank you for watching.